A fast-moving threat that changes course in a heartbeat. Sarpy County deputies race the ice jam along the Platte River, staying ahead of the danger and keeping homeowners safe.
And after all that danger, would you believe snow could be a factor for the morning drive? Good evening. I'm Rob McCartney.
I'm Brandi Peterson. We'll check in with Bill Ramby in just a minute. First, the ice jam that sent some Sarpy County residents scrambling for higher ground today. The threat sent water pouring over 255th just south of Q around 4 p.m. About 2 hours later, the ice made its way to Highway 6, the bridge there near Gretna and Ashland.
Minutes later, a crisis averted at Mahoney State Park. Our crews followed the threat every step of the way. KATV News Watch 7's Adrian Whitsett is live in Sarpy County with the very latest. Adrian.
Yeah, Rob, I'm near the Platte River Bridge, the I-80 bridge near the Mahoney State Park. I don't know what you can exactly see behind me, but it's the bridge and the Platte River, which is moving freely at this hour, and it has been for quite some time. The biggest threat right now is that the water level has seemed to have risen over the last couple hours. Now, this area right here was the third area of concern for emergency workers, who say that as long as the ice doesn't get chunked up here, much of the upriver threat is gone.
The warning came quickly, and soon the Platte River overflowed its Sarpy County banks Wednesday afternoon.
We had an ice jam that was a mile long on the Platte, just west of Vinsel's Island.
Sarpy County Sheriff Jeff Davis says once the flood started, it created problems for those living nearby, saturating fields and overtaking the road.
It did come across the road here on 256th Street. At one point, it was about 2.5 feet deep. There was no way to cross either way.
To make matters worse, the water moved dangerously close to homes along the banks on Vinsel Island. Authorities moved fast, getting two residents out of harm's way.
We were able to get up to the yard. I was able to find the people. We convinced them to come out, brought their oxygen medications.
Within an hour, the threat to Vinsel Island was gone, but the danger wasn't over.
The ice jam did break through. It's got a number of hurdles to clear before we're basically out of the woods.
The next hurdle, the Highway 6 bridge in between Gretna and Ashland. Deputies, along with the State Patrol, monitored the fast-moving ice downstream to here, the Interstate 80 bridge near Mahoney State Park. By the time we arrived, the ice was moving swiftly, and many of the larger chunks seen upriver had already floated by. And the primary concern now is that as more ice chunks break off, they could get stuck near the bridges, once again flooding the areas along the river.
And Brandi and Rob, I spoke with a number of residents down here who say they're not really worried with the ice right now, because it seems like there's less ice here now than there was a couple of years ago when this entire area was underwater. Reporting live in Sarpy County, Adrian Whitsett, KETV News Watch 7.
All right, thanks, Adrian. Now, authorities in Dodge County are also on alert, though, with all eyes on the Elkhorn River. Ice jams sent water over the banks today north of Scribner, but as of tonight, Highway 275 is still open.